This is Andy Porowal for Boxing Social in association with Betfred, and I'm delighted to be joined by Chris Jenkins over Zoom. Chris, how are you doing?
All right, mate. Yourself?
Yeah, I'm good, mate. I'm good. It's good to catch up and to catch up with some fight news for yourself. Finally, you'll be facing Echo Esserman come July 24th. Only recently announced, Chris. So just talk to me about, firstly, how long have you guys been negotiating the new date?
To be honest with you, I don't really know. I've obviously kept myself in the gym. I've kept in shape. We heard something regarding this fight happening this date. Whilst I was sparring with a really, really rival. So, you know, it's on now, 3 weeks Saturday.
3 weeks Saturday, as you say, Chris. I don't know whether preparations is the right word, because it's only just been formally announced. How has kind of your ticking over status in camp been?
It's been good, mate. You know, I've been sparring with, like I said, a team in Sprong, British and Commonwealth champion. I've been sparring with Joe Godina. I've been sparring with the lads in the gym. You know, I've been keeping in shape. So it's all it's about now. It's 3 weeks now of hard work. You know, so I can, you know, people say, oh, you've only had this much notice. It doesn't bother me whether it's 3 weeks, whether it's 8 weeks. It's the same outcome.
Because you've obviously had previous camps preparing for Echo, Chris, how much of a benefit will that be, though, knowing kind of all the tactical work and the foundations they've been laid out previously? It's just kind of getting up to scratch with your own fitness, with your own work.
It's just crossing the T's and dotting the I's at the moment. You know, he's a good fighter. I'm not going to say anything bad about him, because he's mandatory challenger for a reason. No, he's confident, I'm confident, and between you and I honestly think that our fight is going to steal the show.
Chris, just going off that one then, you said you think the fight will steal the show. What do you think everybody should expect when the pair of you are in the ring come July 24th?
It's a great fight, and I'm going to win. That's all, really. I don't really do much studying. I've seen little bits. I leave that to my team. Gary Lockett and Brett Parry, they're the ones who's doing the, and we can see what he's good at, and we can see what he's weak at. So we're going to capitalise on his weaknesses and look out for what he's good at, you know. But it's a fight, and it's been a long time coming, especially after my year, doing my year in. So it'd be nice to get back out there and have a nice win and get a step closer to winning this belt outright.
Just talking about kind of your ear, Chris, obviously that being the reason why you had to pull out of the last fight. How long did it take for you to recover from that? And obviously I saw some previous comments from Echo saying he doesn't know whether that was the true case, that you had an ear injury.
It's up to him whatever he thinks. Like, you know, I went to see a doctor, I got punched on the ear, and basically my ear exploded. It went a nice feeling. I wanted to fight. I was in great shape, but the British Boxing Board of Control are paramount on boxer safety and his life after boxing. So it took about 8 to 10 weeks until I had the all clear. My manager Mo then informed Frank Warren that I'm ready whenever. So, you know, it is what it is. It's happened. It's healed. And I'm sparring now when I've been hit on the ear that they got in. And there's no issue there on.
Because of this extra time, once again, between what was meant to be the last day to this one, Chris, the extra, I imagine, frustration you felt from having to pull out, do you feel that will benefit you come July 24th and you'll want to kind of take out that frustrations and produce an even better performance against Echo? Or is there the risk that because of how frustrated you might be, it might work against you?
Nah, mate, I'm as professional as they come, you know. I'm not looking beyond them. I know what I've got to do. Boxing is an art. And, you know, personally, I think I'm a better boxer than them. You think otherwise, but opinions and opinions are like assholes and everyone's got one. But, you know, this little layoff that we've had, I wouldn't say it's a layoff. I've just been working on certain things that I needed to work on. And, you know, it'll all be shown on the 24th.
When I spoke to Echo a few days ago, or it might have been about a week ago now, he said he's been studying you and he sees some holes that he can exploit in your own kind of skill set. What can you see of his? I know you said you don't tend to study your opponents, but just from what you have seen of him, what do you think you can take advantage of?
And see on the night, that's all I can say. Obviously, no one's the... the 10-10 fighter, you know, everyone's got a little bit of flaws in their game. You know, Floyd Mayweather have, everyone have, Tyson Fury have, Anthony Joshua has, you know, so, you know, he's going to try and say things, I'm going to try to say things, we're going to be basically slating each other, this, that, but at the end of the day, we're going to fight, he's a good fighter, I'm a very good fighter, and roll on fight night.
Chris, a victory for yourself here. Have you thought about what could be next?
No, really, mate. I live my life in a way that you don't run before you can walk. So my main focus, my main drive, all my focus is on this next fight. And whatever happens afterwards, then we sit down and we see what is next. But until then, my goal now is to just beat Echo Esselman, look good doing it, and then you know, we'll see what's next then.
Obviously in the past, just one name I want to touch on is Conor Benn. He was somebody, you know, you was trying to negotiate, but he never came off. Is that something you'd like to revisit, especially because since when you were negotiating that fight, he's obviously continued to improve, he's come on leaps and bounds, and his own kind of profile is shot through the roof even more.
It is what it is. You know, that fight was offered and this and that and all the other little things in between. You know, if we cross paths, we cross paths. At the end of the day, I wish him all the best in his career. He's probably on a different path from where I am at the moment. He's looking towards getting world titles. I'm looking at defending my British belt. So, you know, if we cross paths, we cross. But no, I wish him all the best in his career.
Just one other thing I want to, sorry, just get your thoughts on Chris. He's Michael McKinson. He certainly started to kind of, you know, catch the attention of the British public. Would he be somebody you'd be interested in?
Do you know what? After this fight, it all depends who, you know, I've got a team around me. I've got everyone around me that does all that. You know, if they tell me I'm going to fight, I'm fighting him next. If they tell him I'm fighting someone else, I'm fighting him next. You know, but I got at the respect for Mickey because he's a very good fighter, very awkward southpaw. And when he boxed Congo that time, people were writing him off. And I was like, no, he beat him. And he did. He beat him well as well. He's a very good fighter.
To come away from yourself, Chris, Jay Harris, a campmate of yours, who's unfortunately unable to overcome Ricardo Sandoval in his IBF final eliminator this past weekend. I just want to get your thoughts on Jay's defeat and where next for him.
Jay, I was absolutely gutted, but the lad he boxed, he was 22, but he didn't fight like a 22-year-old. He's special, you know, you wouldn't bring over one of the top men from Golden Boy with a fighter to the UK if he isn't something special. And, you know, for Jay was boxing well. And it's one of them shots. Until you get caught with one of them right in the solar plex, it doesn't matter how many sit-ups you're going to do, they're going to hurt. And, you know, I haven't spoken to Jay now. He's got a young family and stuff. So he'll probably have a few weeks off, get back at the gym, and who knows?
Right, Chris, just before I let you go, I want to leave a final word to yourself because I know your son has been kind of running rings around you today. final word, mate, just obviously everybody's going to tune in on July 24th. Everybody who's going to support you as well. What should they all expect?
I'm just so happy to be back. It's been 20 months, but it's been 20 months of work being put in. And you're going to see a better, a more proved Chris Rock and Roller and still.
Chris, I appreciate your time today. I'll leave you to get back to your fatherly duties. Thank you for speaking to Boxing Social.
No worries, my man. Anytime. I'm going to be stressed now for the next couple of hours of impact. Hey, Boss Family is for. That's what we do it. That's what we box to provide.
No, 100%, mate. Listen, it's a pleasure to catch up with you. Thank you.
Take care, my man.